Now, a Derby electrician has been awarded both the Best Aboriginal Business and Best Regional Small Business Awards in Western Australia. Jonathon Smith was born and raised in the tiny Kimberley town and is creating opportunities for future Indigenous sparkies. WA correspondent Craig Quartermaine reports.
The old port of Derby was once an industrial hub loading livestock and supplies to help establish the multi-million dollar cattle and mining industries. Now, while its more prosperous years may have passed, Derby electrician Jonathon Smith is run off his feet with electrical work and business contracts.
Yeah, no, it's pretty nice. We have worked hard. When we did buy this property, and we've only had it now for just over a year, we were actually over the back there. You'll see there's a couple of sea containers. We worked out of that for about 4 years.
Jono, along with his wife Prue, have gone from two sea containers on a rented block to the modern and award-winning facilities of their company, What Now Electrical.
So now we've obviously got the shed, which has got a two-bedroom unit in it. Predominantly we use that unit for our shorter term contractors that come in and help us out on our bigger contracts. And then obviously it's quite a nice facility with a pool out the back.
What Now Electrical has won Best Regional Small Business and Best Aboriginal Business in WA because of the high standards of their facilities and business model.
You walk through into our smoker area and conference room where we every Monday morning have a bit of a toolbox meeting with the boys. I like to try and keep on top of morale and all that sort of things and make sure if there's any issues that we get on top of those before they become issues.
It's a far cry from when Jono started his apprenticeship in Derby.
Yeah, well, obviously being an Indigenous boy myself in Derby, I over the years have seen a lot of my mates that I went to school with that sort of didn't have the family support that I had and the sort of drive to want to better themselves fall into the traps of drugs and alcohol and all that sort of stuff. So I'm very aware of how quickly it can take hold of people.
Jono's wife is a doctor as well as his business partner. She handles the administrative side of the company, all while helping raise their small family, which is a huge motivator for them to contribute back to their community through the business.
I guess being such a small town, we feel quite privileged and lucky to have what we have. Obviously we've worked hard to get it, but I guess we feel that sense of wanting to give back to our community now, and obviously now we're in a position where we can do that.
Supporting local organisations and sporting clubs in Derby are only a few of the projects What Now has enabled Jono and Prue to become involved in. There are two Indigenous apprentices at the company under Jono, with a focus on encouraging women and girls to take on an apprenticeship.
I really want to see Indigenous people be able to strive and succeed and know what they can do. I'm not saying that, you know, the average normal Australian white person can't do the same thing and doesn't have the same issues, but obviously, you know, you can only look back in the early 80s here and my grandfather couldn't even have a beer in the pub with his mate, you know. So it's not that long ago that we were suppressed to the fact that we weren't even people.
Jono's mother was a school teacher, but it was his stepfather who actually encouraged him to leave school early to start his apprenticeship. He looks back on what could have been a very awkward conversation fondly.
It was quite an easy conversation actually, because by sort of the end of year nine, I really wasn't enjoying school academically. I loved doing things with my hands. So my mum is actually a school teacher, so she organised to do some work experience in different areas.
The relationship Jono has with his parents laid the foundations for his future success. He was recently recognised for his work in the community as a Top 40 Under 40, which is a program that celebrates the most successful entrepreneurs under the age of 40.
Good evening to you all and welcome to the 2017 40 Under 40 Awards, where once again we recognise excellence amongst WA's young business elite.
After trying carpentry and mechanical training, Jono started his electrical apprenticeship at the very site where he runs What Now From. It's a hard slog, but he credits his family's support for where the company is today.
Oh yeah, it'd pretty much be impossible without Brooke, to tell you the truth. She's obviously she keeps me very grounded and sort of makes sure that, you know, she is that ear for me to talk to when I go home with all my problems and issues, and no matter how big or small they might feel to me, at least I know that I've got that support there at home to kind of listen to me whinge, I guess.
Like any good electrician, he knows where to find his spark.